Dear learners, welcome back to this MS-012 ecosystem and natural resources. You know, in previous session of the this block 4 of this course in agro biodiversity, we have learned about the basic of agro biodiversity, how we have to understand from the lens of sustainability point of view. You know, we have learned about the importance of agro biodiversity from the different perspective. And today, the major focus of this session will be in synchronizing agro biodiversity, right? An overview. In this, you know, after learning about, you know, importance of agro biodiversity, and now we learned that because of one or other factors, and the agro biodiversity is losing day by day. So we need to understand how it is shrinking from the last 2-3 centuries. So, and the pattern of agro biodiversity loss and how it is declining, the reason behind declining the agro biodiversity. And you know, sometimes when we talk about agro biodiversity, you know, we sometimes do not take animal genetic diversity as a part of it, but we learned that this very much part of it. So we'll also look in what are the major threats of animal genetic biodiversity, agro biodiversity. So in this, we are going to have a comprehensive picture of different aspects of the loss of agro biodiversity and trying to explore different factors that are responsible for depleting status of agro biodiversity, and you know, how intensification of agriculture as dominant force that have a drastic impact or drastically reducing the agro biodiversity. Also, we are going to discuss on this unit. So, when you talk about, you know, a brief understanding about synchronizing biodiversity, we know that biodiversity is vital for human survival, and the role played by biodiversity in our food security and other aspects. We have learned that it's in a consumptive and non-consumptive value, and different values provided by the mother nature in the form of biodiversity. And the major challenge when you talk about agro biodiversity in particular is that, you know, there is agricultural development is happening, especially in an intensive way from the last 21st century. The major objective of this intensive agricultural development is to secure food for all people. And you know, on the other hand, when we are talking, we are looking for towards that direction, we need to protect the agricultural biodiversity on which both we in the future generation largely depends for our food security. And if you look into the Millennium Ecosystem Assessment, that concludes that human activities have led to a more rapid loss of biodiversity on Earth over the past 50 years than ever before in human history. That is, we have learned about the different impact of human activities on degrading the ecosystem, degrading the environment, the pollution we are creating, right? So, this particular Millennium Ecosystem Assessment that argued that the loss of species and the progressive homogenization of many ecosystems, this continue to be one of the main threats to the survival of our natural as well as socioeconomic system. We know the interlinkages between this natural system and socioeconomic system. So this and in that intensification of agriculture in one side, and in the same time the homogenization, I mean, when you intensified agriculture, homogenization of agricultural ecosystem also happening. These have led to significant losses in agro biodiversity. No. Like, you know, the loss of crop and livestock species and genetic diversity, as well as crop associated biodiversity, like, you know, some of this pest suppression biodiversity, pollinator, soil biodiversity, and so on, right? And if you look into how agro biodiversity losing, you will find out that agro biodiversity loss that is comprised. Especially when you talk about agro biodiversity loss, it is about the erosion of genetic diversity, means genetic erosion. So genetic erosion in agro biodiversity is the loss of genetic diversity, including, as I told you, the loss of individual genes and the loss of particular combining of genes, such as, you know, those manifested locally adapted land resistance. And if you exactly look into the term genetic erosion, and it is, you know, when we are trying to understand this the term, and if you know, this is a kind of, you know, narrow sense of understanding. Such as when we talk about genetic erosion, we talk about the loss of alleles or genes, SLOEs. If you look then broadly, it referred to the loss of varieties and varieties, even species, different species of agrobiodiversity. So we need proper management of agricultural biodiversity, right? Without that, some of the key function of the agroecosystem, it may be lost. It is not about the losing of land resources, it is not about losing of only single species genetic resources, it is losing about agroecosystem as system. So there is, you know, maintenance of nutrient and water cycle, pest and disease regulation, pollution, pollination, and the number of erosion control, as we talk about ecosystem services by agrobiodiversity, we have talked in the last session. Erosion of agricultural biodiversity, you know, when it is declining, it has negative impacts on the long-term sustainability of agricultural system. And in fact, when we look into that especially, it has direct impact on the food security, especially on those group of poor people living in marginal lands, right? So there are a number of factors that are responsible for agrobiodiversity erosion. One of the factors is replacement of local varieties by SYB or exotic. SYB means high yielding varieties, or exotic varieties, or these are one of such factors. So a large number of varieties are dramatically reduced when commercial varieties, what we're talking about, that genetically modified organisms, if they are introduced into traditional farming system. That we have learned a number of such kind of issues in your newspaper across the globe. The impact of GMOs, we're talking about GMO is giving food security, but in the same time it has, if you look into the impact, it has, you know, a number of and that limitation, right? We have to understand that. So if you look into the different publication by researchers, many researchers across the globe, their belief is that the main problem related to ecosystem is the general tendency towards genetic and ecological uniformity imposed by the development of modern agriculture, right? So the pressure for that ecological uniformity on farmers and breeders are caused by the food industry demand for more and more raw material and its consistency. And in the same time, we know that intensification of agricultural activities are happening, and when there is agricultural intensification and its corollary, the simplification, simplify the agriculture landscape, there are also some of the factors that are responsible for the loss and the profound modification of biodiversity, in particular over the last few decades, that is in an evidence in front of us across the globe, especially in India also. So in that process, agricultural areas represent, if you look into that, most of the country, how intensification is happening, you will find out that most of the agricultural areas, they represent a majority of the land area of many countries. This is the fact. So it holds the key to the conservation of all the remaining borders. Means when most of the majority of land area of the countries are agricultural areas. So when we conserve that agricultural area or that agrobiodiversity, that has, one of the key approach to that biodiversity. So there are some innovative biodiversity farming system, and such kind of system can potentially be the high yielding and sustainable, and thus support persistence of wild species by limiting adverse effect of agriculture natural habitat. So such kind of approach needs to be followed. So adoption of farming practices that utilize and conserve biodiversity, that may be the ultimate improve environmental quality and limit agricultural. The point is we must try to avoid intensification of agriculture in horizontal way, right? Now when we talk about what are the pattern of agrobiodiversity loss, and if you look very briefly, because as a student of sustainability science, we know that since 1900, more than 75% of plant genetic diversity has been lost as farmers worldwide they have left their multiple local varieties and land races for genetically uniform means high for SYV varieties. So point is that when we used to follow that multiple varieties of the cultivation of multiple varieties, now we are looking into a single varieties, that's called monoculture. So, and again, if you look, 30% of livestock breeds are at risk of extinction. And if you look accurately, that about 6 breeds are losing each month. Today, 75% of world's food is generated from only 12 plants and 5 animal species. You can easily understand all those plants, right? Of the 4% of 250,000 to 300,000 non-endemic plant species, only 150 to 200 are used by human. We know from that when we're talking about the last session, in the last previous session about that crops we are growing, 3 major species, rice, maize and the wheat, they contribute nearly 60% of the calories and proteins obtained by human from plants. At the same time, animals provide 30% of human requirement for food and agriculture, and 12% of the world's population that live almost entirely on product from plants. This is the pattern what we are able to understand from a literature review that's conducted by different authors. More than 90% of crop varieties, that are disappearing from farmers' field. Half of the breeds of many domestic animals have been lost. This, with the disappearance of these harvested species, varieties, and breeds, a wide range of unharvested species are also disappearing with them. For example, now if you look into any of the that land races, you will find out that there are close relation with wild varieties over there. So when you lose the, in ecological time, when you lose the keystone space, then many more hidden species also losing. So again, if you look into fisheries, all the world's 17 main fishing ground are now their bank fees at or above sustainable limits, with many fishes population effectively becoming extinct. So, and same time, when you look into the loss of forest cover, coastal wetlands, or the cultivated areas, and the destruction of the aquatic environment, they exacerbate the genetic erosion of agrobiodiversity. So, locally varied food production system. You will see they are threatening because of all this, including the local knowledge. When you there is loss of your food production system in local level, then that also have that impact to the local knowledge and culture and skills of the farmer, because when it lose, then other associated activities also losing day by day. So one day it will be extinct, your knowledge will also be extinct from that area. Okay. Of total of 7,616 livestock breeds studied by Food and Agricultural Organization, around 20% breeds are classified at risk. This is the magnitude of the pattern of agrobiodiversity loss across the globe. What is the reason behind it? Let us have a quick look into region of decline in agrobiodiversity. We know that throughout the 20th century, decline has accelerated along with increased demands from a growing population and greater competition for natural resources. There are many reasons for decline in this agrobiodiversity. The major factor leading to agrobiodiversity region, if you look into that, those factors are number one, we can say we must say rapid expansion of industrial and green revolution. Right? We know that the advantage means industrial expansion and green revolution, but in the same time it has a limitation, right? This is one of the reasons of decline in agrobiodiversity. Then second is globalization of food system and marketing. As we have shown that evidence in front of us, when there is globalization of food system, and its marketing system then that has direct impact to the local land ratios. Then replacement of traditional variety by improved exotic varieties and species. That is, we know that SYP, GMO, they have, threatening direct to the local land ratios and local varieties. Then we are continuously clearing our land, for one or other purpose, and that has, sometimes, in the name of developing our areas, we are, encroaching to the agricultural land also. Then over-exploitation of species because of the importance of species and because of its high demand, we are over-exploiting the species. Then, we know that everything happens is because of population pressure and because of the environment degradation happening. When environment degradation is happening, that has also again direct impact to the agrobiodiversity. Then grazing, overgrazing and changing agricultural system, and the policy is also one of the important reason, right? Because we need to change the agricultural system, policy is deserved by the population pressure. So when we change it, we have to keep in mind about the impact on that, right? So when you talk about a rapid expansion of industrial and green evolution, we know that it is one of the major driving force that leads to declining crop biodiversity. That include when we have expansion by industrial and green evolution, have direct impact into the whole system, agriculture system. That includes the process include intensive livestock production happening. When we implement industrial expansion of industry and expansion of green evolution, then we follow, in most of the time, when you take an example, fisheries and aquaculture, we do in industrial and in a big scale, that has direct impact, right? And if you look, when we talk about a green evolution, it is high yielding varieties, and that if you look from animal point of view, high yielding breeds, right? So relative few crop varieties are cultivated in monoculture, and when we follow the green evolution, a limited number of domestic animals and breeds or fish are rare, or few aquatic species are cultivated in this, right? This is the reason why there is impact losing that our agrobiodiversity, right? Then coming to how globalization of the food system marketing has impacted to our that agrobiodiversity, extension of industrial patenting and other intellectual property system to living organism, that has led to the widespread cultivation and rearing of fewer varieties in the branch. Because of this, it results in a more uniform way than less diverse but more competitive global market. So as a consequence, there have been changes in farmers and consumers' perceptions, preference, living condition. Then marginalization of a small scale diverse food production system that conserve farmers varieties of crops and breeds of domestic animals. There is reducing integration of livestock in arable production, which reduces the diversity of uses of for which livestock are needed, right? So because of that, then it reduces use of nursery fisheries technique that conserve and develop aquatic biodiversity. Then again, when you talk about, when we understand that there is a replacement of local varieties by improved or exotic varieties and species, then we will see that has direct impact on genetic resources of traditionally are locally available varieties, as we call varieties with the farmers. So when we implement such kind of, we replace that local varieties by improved exotic varieties and species, what happened? That genetic erosion is happening by replacing those or that land ratios with the newer varieties. So genes and gene complex, which has found many farmers varieties, are not contained in modern varieties, right? So that has direct impact to that agricultural system. Well, if you look into some of the report that is published by Food and Agriculture Organization 1996, that states that some indicators of genetic erosion have been developed. Few systematical studies of genetic erosion of crop genetic diversity have been met, but in its report, nearly all countries on that report, it also reflected that nearly all countries, they confirm genetic erosion is taking place, and that is a serious problem. The point is that when we talk about genetic erosion, it is not a question of for a country or for two, three countries, it is across the world. Then let us look into, we have understand about that especially plant and agrobiodiversity. Let us look into especially with special focus on what are the threats to genetic diversity, animal genetic diversity. Based on FAO's Global Data Bank for Animal Genetic Resources for Food and Agriculture, now in that report, then the number of they have identified or they have listed more than 7,616 livestock breeds, right, is as a resources for food and agriculture. So as far as when you talk about these livestock breeds are concerned, around 20% of reported breeds are classified as risks. Of even greater concern is that during the last more than 10 years, 62 breeds became extinct, amounting to the loss of almost one breed per month. So if you look into that also, that is only picture of some of the countries which we have closely studied, right? So the breed inventory, particularly survey of population size and structure at breed level, are inadequate. Point is that when we are restricted to some country, our study is very limited to some region. When we have this much percentage of magnitude, we'll see what we can, how much magnitude will be if we are properly study in a global scale and proper planning. So right, so some of the threats that is identified to genetic diversity, marginalization of traditional production system. This is one of the most significant threats, and the associated local breeds. That now when we talk about this marginalization of traditional production system and the associated local breeds, when it happened, there is the rapid spread of intensive livestock production at large scale and utilizing a narrow range of breeds, right? So that automatically has a direct impact in breeds, okay, the local breeds. Again, if you look into the global production of meat, milk and egg, that X, then it's increasingly based on limited number of high output breeds. And that is one of the reasons we are focusing on all those breeds only, because all those new breeds, they have highly profitable, and that they scale up very easily in industrial production system. So the intensification process has been driven by this rising demand for animal product, and it's also facilitated by the ease with genetic material production and production technology inputs moving around one group another. Okay, so intensification, industrialization, that have contributed to raising the output livestock production and to feeding the growing human population. However, we can take some policy measures to minimize the potential loss of the global public goods embodied in animal genetic resource diversity. So acute threats such as major diseases like epidemics and disasters of various kinds, they are also a major concern to that have directives to this genetic diversity. For example, sometimes we are facing the swine flu, bird flu, etc., that have geographically concentrated at bred population. So threat of such kind that cannot be eliminated, but their impacts can be mitigated. So preparedness is essential when you talk in this context as an ad hoc action. It has happened improve the system, right? So here you will see the factors affecting global agrobiodiversity loss in this figure, which is adapted from Brown et al. You will see here what are the causes of agrobiodiversity loss. We'll see here in genetic resource substitution under investment in sustainable agroecosystem. System we have, you know, when population growth, there is market failure, intervention failure, global appropriation failure of those agrobiodiversity. So when you look into that, you know, that have we need to change the policy for agrobiodiversity for sustainable use. So when we talk about the agrobiodiversity contributions, you know, we need to tag pollution legal framework that influence that conservation of biodiversity in general and agrobiodiversity in particular. So some of the, you know, hidden government subsidies also can be promoted, you know, that also prompted, for example, when we introduce from bread varieties, you know, government used to give subsidies that often promoted development of large scale production at the expense of the smaller system that utilize local genetic resources. So development intervention, disease control strategies, post-disaster rehabilitation program that can also pose a threat to genetic diversity if they do not ensure that the breeds are used are appropriate to local production environment needs for intended beneficiaries. So point is that when we understand the impact of that the label and the impact of that loss of agrobiodiversity and genetic diversity, we need to implement profit strategies for the low external input production system for the developing world, but still it is a great challenge. You know, pastoralists and smallholders are the guardian of such kind of livestock biodiversity, so we need to protect their livelihood also. So their capacity to continue this role means those smallholder farmer pastoralists may need to be supported by ensuring sufficient access to grazing land and, you know, needs of the world. If I summarize here, you know, what we have discussed today's session is, you know, we talk about brief or shrinking agrobiodiversity, pattern of agrobiodiversity loss in brief, since we are studying on from the lens of sustainability science, we are not, looking in details about that, the region of decline in agrobiodiversity and major threats to animatic diversity. And also, we have discussed causes of agrobiodiversity loss and how to tackle all this. Thank you. Thank you very much.